Hello everyone, I am Pallavi Mahagavkar. I am working as an assistant professor at Arts, Commerce and Science College. This lecture series is developed according to the syllabi given by Savitribai Phule Pune University for the subject electronics, particularly microcontroller. Today we are going to focus on TMOD register. As we know that 8051 contains two timers, that is timer 0 and timer 1. So to select the particular mode of that particular timer, one need to assign the bits which are reserved into TMOD register. So let us look at the bit format of this TMOD register. This TMOD is 8-bit register, and whenever you want to load the value for the TMOD, it is byte addressable. So this TMOD register is not bit addressable. So if you want to change any bit from this TMOD register, you have to find out the total 8-bit value, and then you can load that value into TMOD register. So that is the byte addressability of this TMOD register. As I have drawn 8-bit format, this 8-bit format, the lower 4 bits are reserved for timer 0 and upper 4 bits are reserved for timer 1. Now let us look at the bit format for this 4 bit. The lower 4 bits are for timer 0. The first one is gate control bit. The next one is C/T bar. C stands for counter and this T bar stands for the timer action. As we know that these timer and timer which we can have in 8051, that timer we can use as a timer or we can use them as a counter. So for that, either timer or counter selection, we have this C/T bar bit. Then next two bits are used to set the timer mode. So these two bits are used to set the timer mode. We have four timer modes for each timer. Then same four bits are there for timer one also. We can recognize same bits we have for timer 0 and timer 1. The bit number is different. So the higher or MSB bit is gate bit of timer 1, and this fourth bit of TMOD register is for timer 0 register. Now let us look at the each bit function. First of all, we'll go for this M1 and M0 value. As we have two bits reserved in this timer T mode selection bit, we have four modes of operation. What are that four modes? This is M1 and M0. This is mode of your timer and actual function of that timer mode. First of all, we'll look for the value 00. So when M1 value is 0, M0 value is 0, this mode of timer is called as timer 0 mode. What is the meaning of this timer 0 mode? We can have 13-bit timer using this 0th mode. So 13-bit timer means maximum value which you can load into the timer is all 13 bits 1, and minimum value which you can load into the timer is all 13 bits 0. So for that matter, how we can write the value for this? We will use THX, which is timer high byte. So 8-bit higher byte of this first 8-bit is loaded into timer high byte and remaining 5 bits are loaded bits and TLX will have 3 bits. So this 13 bit timer, so 8 bits from TH register and 3 bits from TL register, so total 5 bits, so total are your 13 bit. Now next one is M0 1. This mode is timer 1 mode, which is called as 16 bit timer mode. So when we have total 16 bit, we have to use both THX and TLX register. So THX will have 8 bit and TLX will have 8 bits. So this is your 16 bit timer mode. The next mode is very interesting, which is M1 value is 1, M0 is 0. This mode is called as mode 2 of the timer. This is 8 bit auto reload. So what is this 8 bit auto reload? You can load the value into THX which you want to assign. That value you will load into THX register, which is 8 bit. This 8 bit value is automatically reloaded into TLX for the backup purpose. So this is auto reload mode of your timer. The next is 1 1, that is M1 is having 1 value, M0 is having 1 value. This mode is called as timer mode 3, which is split timer mode. So this is the 4th mode of the timer. So this is all about the mode selection of timer. So we will use M1 and M0 bits for that matter. Depending upon the timer, either it is timer 0 or timer 1, we will have the value assigned to this. So this is your timer mode. Now let us look at the function of C/T bar. Now what is C/T bar stands for? C stands for counter. So whenever you want to use timer of 8051 as a counter, you have to set this bit as 1. So we will set C/T bar bit to 1, meaning that you are using this timer as a counter purpose. Then if you want to use this timer as a timer mode, then you have to assign 0 value for this. That's why we have written C/T bar. C means it is activated only when you are setting the value, and T bar means it is active low. So whenever you want to use timer, then you will write 0 value to this. So this is about the counter and timer selection. Now let us look at the last bit, which is gate control. So this is actually gate control bit of TMOD register. Now what is this gate control bit? We can have, we can start the timer either by software, or you can have the hardware turn on and turn off for the timer. Now whenever you want to start and stop the timer using software, you have to write 0 value to this gate control. So the controlling action of timer is done by software. Now what about the 1 value? When you will assign 1 to this gate control bit, means you are starting and you are starting and stopping the timer of timer with hardware which is connected, which is hardware interrupt, which is connected at P3.2 and P3.3, which are the external hardware interrupt. So you are taking the pulses or you are starting and stopping the timer using that two pins of microcontroller. So this is about the gate control bit of TMOD resistor. Same bit structure we have for timer 1 also. Now we'll take one example. Suppose I have to use timer 0. I want to use timer 0 as a timer. As a timer. And I'm going to use software turn on and turn off for the timer. That is, I'm going to start and stop the timer using software. So T0 I'm going to use as a timer. And mode for this timer is mode 2. So mode 2 is our 8-bit auto reload mode. How we are going to find out the value for these inputs? As we are using timer 0, we will give the total focus for lower 4 bits. So the upper 4 bits are 0. So, but we are not concerned about the timer 1. As in the example we have given timer 0, we will give our total focus for lower 4 bits. This timer we are using as a timer. See, gate control we will always keep it 0 maximum time in general. What about C/T bar? In the example it is assigned as a timer. So whenever you want to use this mode as a timer mode, it is T bar. T bar means active low. So we will write the 0 value for this. Now we will give the focus for M1 and M0 value. What is this mode 2? Mode 2 means M1 and M0 is having value 10. So I will write 10 for M1 and M0 respectively. Now as we have discussed, this TMOD resistor is not bit addressable. So we need to find out the hexadecimal value for this particular bits, these particular bits. So I will write 4 bits and lower 4 bits. So this is 0010 means this is 2, and this is 0000 means 0. So in hexadecimal, what we are getting in hexadecimal number system, we are getting TMOD is equal to 02H. So to set timer 0 in mode 2 in TMOD register, we have to load this 02 value. So this is a syntax in C language. This TMOD is equal to 0x02, meaning that you are loading hexadecimal number 02 into your TMOD register. So 0x stands for the hex value. And if you want to write the same thing into assembly language, we will write move TMOD comma hash 02H. So this is a structure to in assembly language. So meaning that destination is hash indicates immediate value, 02 indicates the actual value, H indicates hexadecimal number, and this is the source. So this source value is moved into TMOD register. So this syntax is for assembly language and this syntax is for your embedded C language. So just by loading the value 02 into TMOD, you are getting timer 0 in mode 2. Now, one question for your learning purpose or as an assignment. If I have instruction like TMOD is equal to 0x01, then what will be the mode of the timer and what is the timer number? Either you are using timer 0 or 1 and what is the mode? This is the first example. Then you have to solve the second one also. That is, if TMOD is equal to 0x20. So I am writing the code in embedded C. So for both the values, you have to state which timer we are using and in which mode. So this is all about the TMOD register. To summarize the lecture, we have TMOD register which is 8 bit. It is byte addressable. It is split into four bit format. Lower 4 bits are for timer 0. Higher 4 bits are for timer 1. And we have gate C oblique T bar M1 and M0 for lower byte, that is for timer 0. And same bit we have for timer 1. And depending upon the mode, we will write the value into M1 and M0. So for these two examples, please write your answer in comment section. Thank you.